A few years ago, I wrote The Ugly Duckling Goes to Work as a way to share with people what we could learn as adults from Hans Christian Andersen. And one of his best-known tales is the story of the ugly duckling. So in this story, for example, in his search, he goes through some terrible, terrible experiences. And finally, he finds safety in a little dilapidated house that is so shaky in its foundation, it doesn't know whether it should fall to the left or to the right, and so this little house remains standing. And there's a huge crack that the ugly duckling slips in through to get away from the elements and the dangers. And in this little house is a cat and a hen. And those two creatures represent that narrow-minded, self-satisfied and smug citizen that Hans Christian Andersen struggled with all his life. This little ugly duckling, who is really a baby swan, isn't meant to be indoors. It's meant to be outside on the water. Being cooped up indoors, the duckling begins to remember the water, to dream of the water, and to say to the cat and the hen, "Don't you ever miss the water?" So the whole journey in this book is about it finally leaving the safe harbor, going back into the world, and after a horrible winter, finding the group where it belongs, finding the element where it belongs. So this is really a story about growing into your full potential, finding the place where you can thrive, where people can see what it is you can contribute. What I did in the book is the book starts with, you know, this very depressed looking creature going to work because there's no joy in his life. He is someplace where he doesn't belong. And not only that, when you get into the story, here's an image of the hen giving the ugly duckling a performance review, kind of like, you know, well, on this issue here, you're sort of in the 40th percentile, and what we would like to do is see you bring it up, you know, about 5 points within the next quarter. And so we're trying to make the duckling conform to the element where he's been placed. And the image shows the duckling looking out the window where there's a flock of swans flying by, knowing this is not the right fit. And at the back of the book, we have an image of the duckling finally finding where it belongs and taking to the sky. And I like it. It's got its tie on. It's its work that makes it thrive. When the illustrator first did it, there was no tie on it. And I said, no. It's not like you take off when you're not at work. You take off with your work. That's a joy.